Revelio.
So frustrating. You wanted to speak with me, Mother?
I had hoped to speak with you alone, Natsai.
Your message mentioned your concern about an unusual creature that was spotted in the woods near Hogsmeade. That could have been anything.
You know what it was, Natsai.
I am allowed to leave the castle. I am always careful, Mother.
Careful? Officer Singer disagrees. She sent me an owl telling me that you have been trying to collect evidence of some kind against dark wizards. She berated me for not keeping a closer eye on you, and she is right. I do not want you visiting Hogsmeade for the near future.
But Mother!
My little gazelle, you are well-intentioned, but you must not meddle in the affairs of dangerous people.
If someone had meddled in Matabeleland, Father would still be with us.
I must get to class. Perhaps your friend can get you to listen to reason.
So frustrating. She never listens to me.
She called you her little gazelle. Is that a term of endearment where you're from?
It is specific to me. I am the unusual creature in Hogsmeade she mentioned. Self-transfiguration is not taught at Hogwarts. So I am gently discouraged from practicing it. However, I am an animagus. And it is in my gazelle form that I have been able to wander the highlands rather freely until now. Much to my mother's chagrin. That is how I managed to spy on Rookwood and Harlow.
Now the nickname makes sense. What an extraordinary ability to have.
It is. I love transforming, but Mother is less enthusiastic about it. She says that no creature, especially one as rare as a gazelle, should be bounding about where poaching has become so prevalent. She claims that she has foreseen tragedy befall me in my gazelle form. But she has used her sight to control me too many times. I no longer believe it.
We're making good progress. We can't quit now.
I agree. I have never considered quitting, even for a moment. You could have fled the moment you discovered that Rookwood, Harlow, and Randrock were after you, but you did not. I choose to act as you have. I must deal with Rookwood and Harlow, not hide from them. My mother cannot know where I am all the time. Thank you for being here during that rather awkward conversation.
duelist to beat.
It's one of those tables Professor Shaw mentioned.
And I never heard the rumors of your involvement.
Over here. This is a change of pace from our last outing.
Don't remind me. The thought of that tent still makes my blood boil. I've been thinking about those poor dragons in the fighting ring. The collars they were wearing, they appeared to be goblin silver. I think a collar is precisely what we found at that poacher camp. I've never known poachers to use anything like that before.
The dragon that attacked my carriage was wearing a collar, and Professor Fig was genuinely baffled by its behavior.
That attack always did strike me as a little strange, seemingly coming out of nowhere. Surely you aren't suggesting that the collars somehow control the poor creatures?
Exactly.
Merlin, I don't think the dragon we set free was wearing a collar, but we should check. And if we can find her, we can return her egg.
That's a good idea. We need to see this through.
I'll start looking into it right away. There was something else that I wanted to discuss with you. I didn't want to press it before. It seems I may have caused you more trouble with Victor Rookwood. Why is he after you?
Rookwood is working with Ranrok, and Ranrok is after something I found at Gringotts. Fig had a portkey that led us there after the dragon attack. It's a bit of a long story, and Fig had asked that I not speak of it yet.
Goodness, Well, that certainly helps to shed light on what we saw at the tent. Don't worry, I'll guard your secret as if it were my own. I shan't press for more details. In fact, I should probably be going. I'd like to track that dragon down as soon as I can. I'll let you know when I have news of her location.
I wonder if I'm safe to explore in there. Revelio.
You're here. Good.
Sebastian, that relic you mentioned.
I believe one of Slytherin's students stumbled upon the relic during an assignment to study sarcophagi in this catacomb. From what I read in a report by the student, they weren't permitted to take it with them, so I must assume it's still here. As I mentioned earlier, this relic grants its holder the power to reverse dark magic curses. If it's in this catacomb, I have to find it. For Anne. I need to see her.
I'd be interested to know what else the student discovered.
Have a look. Unfortunately, there's no name on it, but I suspect if it was important enough for Slytherin to stash in his spellbook, it's worthy of further study.
I'm ready to explore the catacomb. Perhaps we can visit Anne when we've finished.
Perfect. By the way, Ominous has been asking about you. You didn't tell him what we were doing, did you?
I didn't, I promise.
Good. Ominous would be livid if he knew what we were about to do. I'll be interested to compare what lies inside to what I've read about this catacomb. I'm sure that foul smell is the scent of success. Try not to lose your nerve just yet.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Don't start.
Revelio.
This room is taller than it looks. Sarcophagi can be opened. Finding a chest in an inconspicuous loft. Brilliant.
Rebellion.
Thank you.
Revelio. Confringo. Revelio. Revelio. Confringo.
rebellion.